Welcome to the PV online course. This chapter treats the characteristics of a solar cell. We will deal in this teaching unit the series and shunt resistance and their influence on the JV curve of a solar cell. In the last teaching unit, we derived a simplified equivalent circuit diagram, which is shown here. The diagram here is rotated with respect to the one shown in the previous teaching unit. We modeled the solar cell as an ideal power source, and the electrical behavior of the p-n junction using a diode connected in parallel. Note that we assumed an ideal solar cell, meaning a solar cell without losses. However, in a real solar cell, a number of losses occur. First of all, in a real solar cell, there are ohmic losses. They occur due to the resistance of the semiconductor material, the contacts and the leads, and the contact semiconductor interfaces. These losses can be modeled by a so-called series resistance or series resistor, which is connected in series with the solar cell. Let's have a look at the mathematical description and implement the series resistance into the equation. For the ideal solar cell, the current at the terminal is the photocurrent minus the current flowing through the diode. We can express the diode current using the Shockley equation. Since there is now an additional voltage drop due to the series resistance, the terminal voltage can now be described by the diode voltage minus the voltage drop across the series resistance. We can express the voltage drop across the series resistance as the product of the total current and RS. In other words, the diode voltage is the sum of the terminal voltage and the voltage drop across the series resistor. We now insert this expression into the diode equation. In addition to the ohmic losses, there can be the occurrence of current paths that are parallel to the actual p-n junction. These currents can arise, for example, from material defects such as microcracks. In the equivalent circuit diagram, we model these alternative current paths using a parallel resistor or shunt resistor that is connected in parallel to the diode. Now let's insert the shunt resistance in the equation for the solar cell current. So far, the total current resulted from the photocurrent minus the current flowing through the diode. This has not changed with the series resistance either, since the current flow in a series circuit is the same everywhere. But now an additional current flows through the shunt resistor. Like the diode current, we must subtract this current from the photocurrent in order to obtain the total current. With the voltage drop across the series resistance, the equation takes the form as shown here. We want to replace the current I shunt through the shunt resistance with the measurable quantities. I shunt corresponds to the voltage drop across the shunt resistance divided by R shunt, the shunt resistor. The voltages in a parallel circuit are the same everywhere. Therefore, we can replace V shunt with the diode current or the relationship just developed between VD and the terminal voltage. The total current through the solar cell can now be described by the equation in the bottom. It is now much more complicated than the case of the ideal diode, of course. Since the overall current I appears on both sides of the equation, this equation can no longer be solved analytically. Instead, numerical methods are used. This model of a solar cell is called the single diode model. For most purposes, the single diode model is sufficiently accurate. With the equation resulting from the single diode model, we can now look at the influence of the series and shunt resistance on the JV curve of a solar cell. We first consider a solar cell without shunt resistance. The last term in the equation is therefore deleted. If we increase the series resistance, the exponential function reaches high values even at lower voltages. Therefore, the current through the diode becomes larger. This leads to an earlier bending of the JV characteristic. If we increase the series resistance further, we can observe that the JV curve becomes flatter and the knee of the curve shifts to lower voltages. The short circuit current remains almost unchanged, but in the open circuit voltage, the slope of the characteristic curve becomes smaller and smaller as RS increases. Due to the shift of the knee of the JV curve, the point of maximum power also shifts. This has a significant influence on the fill factor. As RS increases, the fill factor decreases. For a high fill factor, the series resistance, hence the ohmic losses of the solar cell, should be as low as possible. Typical values for the series resistance of a commercial solar cell are in the range of 1 ohm centimeter. The series resistance can be extracted from the JV or IV curve. So let's look in detail to the slope of the curve near VOC. The slope is the current divided by the voltage, which is 1 divided by as resistance. In this case, the resistance is the series resistance. The larger the series resistance, the smaller the slope of the JV curve in the range around VOC, so the flatter the JV curve. Let us now consider a solar cell without a series resistance. The current through the diode in this case is that of an ideal solar cell. The term I multiplied by RS in the equation is deleted. The shunt resistance only appears in the last term of the equation. We start our consideration with a solar cell with a large shunt resistance. In this case, the last term can be neglected. Almost no current flows through the shunt resistor. If we reduce the shunt resistance, the JV curve decreases over the entire voltage range because of the linear influence of R shunt. While the short circuit current density remains unchanged, the slope of the JV curve near the short circuit current density decreases. The smaller the shunt resistance becomes, the flatter the JV curve will be at this point. Again, the point of maximum power shifts. The fill factor decreases as the shunt resistance decreases. Typical values for the shunt resistance of a commercial solar cell are in the range of 1000 ohm square centimeter. The shunt resistance can be extracted from the IV characteristic as well. This time we look at the slope of the curve near ISC. The slope of the curve near the short circuit current is 1 divided by the shunt resistance. The smaller the shunt resistance, the flatter the curve will be at this point. The larger the shunt resistance, the more ideal the curve. Let us summarize this chapter. You have learned about the one-diode model. In addition to the similarity of the behavior of a solar cell to a diode, this equivalent circuit model of a solar cell takes into account losses due to resistances. We have seen that these resistances can be divided into series and shunt resistances. For a high fill factor, the series resistance should be as small as possible and the shunt resistance as large as possible. I thank you for your attention.